All right, so this is the opening sequence to Final Fantasy X. I will be doing my best to narrate and describe what you should be seeing on the screen. A lot of it is, in the beginning, it's a lot of credits. So Square Electronic Arts, Squeenix, Squaresoft presents Final Fantasy X Project 1999 to 2002. I'll be trying to read some last names, but I probably actually won't. Never mind. Got a black screen right now with. Now we cut into a scene with a sword point down into the ground, standing up, a staff kind of stuck in the ground, leaning at an angle to the sword. The sword kind of has a bluish crystal kind of tint to it. There is a ball in front of it. Looks like there's a spear as well, or that could be a part of the background. That's probably part of the background. But you have kind of a rough, kind of really brown, rocky terrain. Yeah, so far that's it. In the background of those items, looks like the ruins of a city, like kind of a metallic city. Now we see a group of people by a campfire. You have a woman dressed in black robes with dark hair kind of put up into an intricate bun on top of her head. You have a younger woman who is wearing kind of like a vest, an orangish reddish vest with kind of a bluish cape. Like, it's one of those capes that is split down the middle though, so that's like two parts to it when it flows. And short shorts, short yellow shorts, and like almost knee-high boots or socks. You've got a man, mostly shirtless, but has kind of like a wife beater, like straps that go up to his shoulders and then behind his back. He's got orange hair that sticks up in the front quite a bit, and then kind of like mohawk-y in the front, but then just all sticking up in the back, the top and the back. He's got a blue headband on. He's got yellow pants. Looks like sandals. I keep panning over. We've got a large humanoid shape. These guys are all sitting down. So a large humanoid shape that's got blue fur all over his body. White flowing hair down to just above his shoulder, or just around the middle of his shoulder blades. Kind of like feathery shoulder pads, white feathery shoulder pads, kind of bare back, bare chest. You see the blue fur. He does some armor on. To the left of him is a blonde haired man, kind of goes down maybe to the nape of his neck, in length. He's got a yellow shirt that's kind of just the top part of the shirt and the top part of the sleeves. And then kind of like overalls, it looks like black overalls. There's another man the man wearing yellow also has like shorts and pants kind of combined. The left leg is shorts and the right leg is pants down past the knee. Dark pants, dark shorts. There's a woman wearing a white, kind of looks kind of ceremonial, almost kimono-like or toga-like, but white dress, I would say, with a yellow sash with kind of some vines along it, some green vines along the yellow sash, and white like arm guard kind of things. Like a yellow bow in the back. And her hair is brunette and hangs down just to about her shoulders. She's young. She's about as young as the girl who was wearing orange or yellow. The man wearing yellow put his hand on her shoulder as he got up, and yeah, he's walking off. There's another man wearing red, kind of like a red military-ish outfit. Has dark shades on, dark hair, kind of a serious look to him. Thank you. and Yellow has got up. He's kind of climbed a little bit of a hill, and he's looking out over the ruins of this city. And you have a close-up on his face. He's also got an earring and a chain necklace. I always thought there was a little bit of narration at this point, like, this is my story. But anyway, we still see the credits popping up, like music, producers, dialogue editors, etc. A lot of Japanese names, which I know Japanese is actually pretty easy to pronounce, but they're moving too fast and I don't want to pause it that often, if I can help it. And then Final Fantasy X has come across the screen. And there's kind of like this graphic of, it looks like there is a woman to the left, and like this bluish, fiery flowing, like fiery hair kind of flowing thing that comes from her and down, and then it goes under the Final Fantasy X and back up, and as it goes back up, just in front of the X, it looks like it's kind of becoming more golden and dragon-like, or dragon, maybe Chocobo kind of like. Yeah. That is the opening sequence. You see the executive producer and the loading screen. And this is a new game. It's very loud, but you have the option to turn it up and down. I turned it down a bit. Once again, we see the weapons stuck in the ground and the ruins of the city in the background. This might be where the narration starts. I did not remember us seeing the exact same scene, but I'm not gonna pause it. Hopefully the narration will happen eventually. Get some tea here. It's Thanksgiving today. Chai tea, some chai spice tea with half a shot of Fireball and monk fruit sweetener. And then I actually do a little bit of chocolate Slim Fast flavor. Just a little. It's pretty good. Pretty good combo. Especially if it's cold out. It's perfect.
Listen to my story. This may be our last chance.
We see just a black screen of Final Fantasy X. I remember if I'm supposed to press X here. No, no, it just faded, okay. Load in on the scene of a city. You got some people kind of milling about, wearing bright colors mostly. You got some darker colored, but mostly bright colors. They're all cheering and running off in the same direction. And then there's this kind of lamppost kind of light thing. It's kind of like got this blue swirling circular thing around it that's like the light. And then this ghost child appears wearing a purple hood, bare arms, and like kind of a purple vest, black pants that go down to his knees. And he's walking in the same direction and then fades out as he's walking in the same direction as the crowd did. And then you see the man, the boy wearing the yellow shirt and the kind of the half pants. And you see the crowd is cheering for him. And then we take control and we gotta run down. So it's like we're coming from a ship, which could be like where his house is, like his houseboat kind of thing. We're running down a plank and we can interact with people here. So we can talk to these kids.
Can you sign us?
He's asking him to sign his ball. And we're just gonna say his name is Titus, because that's what his name is in the game.
Please.
Another kid holds
Alrighty.
Up the ball.
Me too.
The last kid holds
Take
up the ball.
Take it easy.
Alright, that's it for the kids. Let's talk to these girls here holding balls.
Can I have your autograph?
Of course.
Good luck tonight.
Nothing to worry about.
He does a little ball twirl on his finger.
If I score a goal, I'll do this.
He put his fingers.
That will mean it was for you.
He put his hands
okay?
in the air and his fingers like claws, basically.
What seat?
He's blocking the front row. Fifth from the right.
Got it.
He's a horrible flirt. We try to move our way through the crowd a bit more and we get a little cutscene.
For me.
Two, three. Teach us how to blitz.
Hey, I got a game to play.
That was teach us how to blitz.
Then teach us after.
Maybe tonight, well.
You can't tonight.
The little shadow boy has said,
I mean,
has said that.
Tomorrow.
Promise?
Promise.
Or ghost boy. They all those kids do like the goal scoring motion, which is they put their hands together in front of them and then they kind of move them up and in a circle, like expanding out from each other. Come on. Now we are seeing all of this city, and it's just this massive city that's built up. I don't know if it's built all like floating on water, but you've got all of these just man-made spires everywhere. There's lights everywhere. It's all metal. It's very grand. You got like really clean highways going in between. There's a big screen that shows a man with a red bandana, his arms crossed. He's got like arm guards on. There's this large waterfall that comes from one of the big buildings. And our main character is just walking down this empty street. He's looking up at the screen with the man with the red headband.
I was in a coffee shop running away from home when I heard the news. Our hero, Jack, gone, banished into thin air. My dad must have been his biggest fan. I knew how sad he'd be. Heck, we all were that day. Zanar, I says to myself, what are you thinking? I went running straight back home. We sat up talking about Jack all night. My dad and I never talked so much. Whoa. Didn't mean to reminisce, folks. Anyway, 10 years later, the Jack Memorial Cup tournament is today. The two teams that have won through to the finals are, of course, the Abes from A East and the Duggles from C South. I know there's a lot of people out there today to see the star of the Abes. In just 1 year, he's become the team's number one player. He's Jack's blood and the new hope of Blitzball. What kind of super play will he show us today? Will we see his father's legendary shot? I don't think I'm the only one excited here, folks.
I'm just talking to all of them. It's not as deserted as I thought. There's a lot of people to talk to, and there's supposed to be somebody that'll give me potions, but maybe that's in a different scene. Anyway, gotta fade to black, kind of. I think it's the start of a cutscene, so I might have some pausing going on here.
Make way.
You are trying to run
into this big.
Like super tall, like portal that kind of just looks like flowing water,
and there's just crowds of people in front. There's not a lot of good security to help the players get into the game, apparently. But you've got two on either side of the opening. There are two like colossal statues that are in kind of a battle pose. They both have pole arms that are pointed up. They've got their left foot forward or right foot forward, depending on which statue it is, and they're like kind of bent down and back a bit, ready to strike. It looks like. Trying to get in here, and I got in. You get to the top. Once you get in, you turn around, you look at the crowd one more time, and then you keep walking in. Alright, so this cutscene is awesome. You're in basically a locker room right now, and you have the guy you've been following. He's just kind of sitting there. He's like sitting halfway in water, so like from the knees down, and including his butt, he's sitting in water, just kind of staring up at nothing, eyes closed, I guess, not staring, getting himself in the zone, and his eye flashes open, and then we have a just brilliant, like lightning kind of glowing ball in the center of this giant sphere. A glass sphere dome thing. This lightning ball. Let's see what happens here. And this this humongous door opens, and the crowd is rushing in. And then you step up. And the crowd cheers. You're stepping into this zone, into this giant sphere, and the lightning ball is kind of shrinking and getting more intense, and then all of a sudden it just flashes bright white, and then you have this zoomed out view of this giant city, and it is built on water, so like everything is either floating or maybe on giant stilts, but probably more likely floating. And maybe it's not the city, maybe this is the stadium that we're flashing out on. But we do pan over the city as well. And when we've panned over the city, we see that man in the red military outfit. And he is atop. If you picture a building, and a tall, tall, tall building, and say that building for some reason has planks built out from the top and just a couple planks. He's basically out on the edge of one of those planks. Don't know why. There's also these really interesting water arches. So if you picture like the Arch of St. Louis or just an arch in general, they look like they're made of water. So just this big, like really super thick arch of water, kind of in the background. There's a couple of them. And the wind is picked up, and this man in red has a jug held out, and he's holding it out toward a massive incoming wave that appears to have some kind of a creature inside of it, like 50, 80 foot tall wave. It just keeps getting bigger and taller, and it keeps coming towards this city. And then you see the game being played. It's a very physical game. It's underwater. Nobody seems to have any trouble breathing, at least in this game. And you got like elbows thrown. They're trying to pass a ball around. You got your star player holding the ball right now, getting run into and molested by an opposing player. The opposing player was like on his back trying to wrestle the ball from him. And the star player picks up the ball, passes it to one of his teammates. His teammate gets hit immediately, knocks the ball loose. One of the opposing team members gets the ball, kind of does a spin move in the water. She's wearing red. You got a close-up of her. Crowd cheers. She gets hit hard by our star player and knocked out of the sphere, which I don't think can happen in the actual game when you play it, but it's still cool. She gets knocked into the stands. Star player looks at her like, yeah, that's right, and then kind of swims off. And then we see outside our red garmented man is walking along just some streets and whatnot, and when he steps in a puddle, the splash from the puddle starts to, the water from that puddle starts to move upwards, defying gravity, being pulled somewhere. And people are running now. You see this massive wave, this massive sphere of water that seems to have its, some massive gravity to it too. It's pulling buildings towards it. And the ball has been scored into the goal. The yellow team by fives. Some more game action, and Titus, our star player, has like swam up and out of the sphere and into the air. And all the other players turn to look, and as he goes up, he starts to do a little bit of a backflip in the air, as if his feet are gonna strike the ball when his feet are above him. And as he's